Shalom, blessings in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. My name is Miriam Rachel. Hi, sheep in the garden. It's your faithful black sheep. Blessings. Oh my goodness, I need my glasses. Okay, we are in the book of Enki. And we just read about, we're in tablet 6, and the first baby was born, shaggy with hair all over. Whew. So, fast was the newborn growing. What on Nibiru a day was, a month in the Abzu, or earth, was. Taller the earth child grew, in the image of the Anunnaki he was not. His hands for tools were not suited, his speech only grunting sounds was. And once again, I'll find a link and put it in the description. We know that the Sasquatch, that's how they talk to each other. We must try once more. And then she continues, she mixes it up again, bit from one, a bit from another, in the crystal bowl, the oval of the Sasquatch she inseminated. There was conception, there was birth giving, this one more in the likeness of the Anunnaki. So it kind of looked more like Anunnaki, which would be reptilian, okay? They let his birth mother him suckle. They let the newborn to a child grow. Appealing he was by his looks. His hands to hold tools were shapen. His senses they tested. They found them deficient. The earth child could not hear. His eyesight was faltered. Again and again and again. Ninma rearranged the admixtures. Okay, so we just showed a picture of them in the last two videos. But I'll go ahead and show it again. These are definitely reptilians. These are not people. This is not Yahuwah. They did not create us. So, one being had paralyzed feet. Another, his semen was actually dripping. Now they're looking for an Anunnaki womb to put the little bowl mixture in. And it says, perchance the perfect primitive worker to create, or a monster in her belly to carry. And they had a volunteer. And longer than on Earth, but quicker than on Nibiru, travail came to a male child Nima birth was giving. Enki, the boy child, held in his hands the image of perfection he was. He handed the newborn to Ninma. She held him up in her hands. And we know, they named him Adamu, but we know that this creature that they created was nothing like us. And that right about at this time, Yahuwah was looking down from heaven at what they were doing to the guardians of his forests. These Sasquatch, that's what they are. They're the guardians of the forests. And they're very wise and they're very ancient and they're from the first world age. They are. And he looked down, Yahuwah did, and he saw what they were doing, this miscegenation. And right about that time is when he literally created us. And as soon as Enki saw the perfect creation that Yahuwah had made, he abandoned his miscegenation experiments and gave all of his attention to us. But we're not that far along in the story. Actually, these tablets of Enki never really talk about that. This is before, just before. This is the miscegenation experiments, and then Yahuwah sent us, you know, we fell. Satanael came into the garden, or Samael, some call him, and beguiled Eve. We know this. And she fell. And then we were here with them. And surrounded by demons that we couldn't see. So we came after this. But it's right before the flood. Now the flood is going to wipe them out. So we know that we're coming into being right around this same time. but they had already been doing the miscegenations. That's what I'm trying to say. That's what I'm trying to establish, is that they had already been doing their miscegenation experiments before we were created. And Yahuwah laughing at their experiments was the reason he created us. And that's what I've learned from scripture. So here they describe him. Shaggy like the wild, they're Adamu, right? Does it sound human to you? Shaggy like the wild ones, he was not. Dark black his head hair was, okay? So far might be human. Smooth was his skin, alligator, okay? Smooth as the Anunnaki skin it was. And you have to realize they are reptilians, so. Now, here it is. Like dark red blood was its color. Like the clay of the Abzu was its hue. So they, I've never seen a human in dark red blood color. We come in, you know, red and yellow, black and white, but not dark red blood. Jesus doesn't have any precious little children with dark red blood skin. So these were not, they don't have the breath of God in them. They can't go to heaven. That's why they're evil spirits bound here on the earth, as we learn from the books of Enoch. All right. And they're arguing whether he's a being or a creature. They think he is a being, but he actually is a creature because he has no spirit of God in him. Then they create what they call Tiamat. Something like that. Yeah. Now we know that Tiamat is the original name of Earth. And this is what Satan's always doing. He's always copying names. This is not our Atom. And this is not our Ua. These are creatures that were created using miscegenation via the Sasquatch. And earthlings in their wombs to conceive and bear primitive workers to create in seven vessels of the clay of the Absu made Nima ovals of the two-legged females placed still using Sasquatch. The life essence of Adamu she extracted bit by bit in the vessels she it inserted. Then in the male part of Adamu, an incision she made, a drop of blood to let out. Ugh. And this is, they're binding themselves to these creatures that they created by swearing. Here it is. To a unity shall the two essences, one, they call themselves of heaven, but they're not of heaven, they're of Nibiru. And their forefathers were banished there, no doubt. And we know Nibiru is just a sulfurous ball of burning. And even when it's described in these tablets of Enki, that's how it's described, as a red burning ball. One of heaven, one of earth, together be brought. They are children of the fallen ones, but they themselves are not, except for maybe Enki. He might have been one of the older ones. But I don't know all the details. I wasn't there. I'm only 50 years old. I can only tell you what I've learned from scripture. And we have bits and pieces. We're very fortunate to have what we have, especially from the Dead Sea Scrolls. Thank you, Father, for this hidden manna. So they bound themselves to Sasquatch, and they said, that which is of earth and that which is from Nibiru, by a blood kinship shall be bonded. So they literally bound themselves by oath. I'd be interested on Judgment Day to see how that pans out for them. Just saying. So they keep doing these things. They're more and more. They a lot of failures. No birth. A month of evil fates. Okay, the 10th month, a month of evil fates, they began to call. They had to do another C-section. A female was born. They were trying to get a female. They'd only gotten males up to that point. But Shaggy, she was not. They pointed that out. Like beach sands was the hue of her red hair, head hair. So she was born white. Beach sands. But beach sands come in all different colors. So let's just assume it's white. Her skin smooth was that of the Anunnaki in smoothness and color it was. So again, it's probably that red-black color. Ew. This time, proper sounds the newborn uttered. But it was an offspring of this Sasquatch. So they named her Tiamat, and they mated her to that other creature they named Adamu. And like the planet of old, of which the earth and moon were fashioned, let her be called. So they know they're calling her after Tiamat. And what do we call it? Plain T, right? Planet, right? Planet Earth. So now this is the account of Adamu and Tiamat in the Eden. At the allotted time, seven female earthlings were born. Good sounds they were uttering. For the seven and seven cages they made, among the trees they placed them. Does that make you mad? I mean, there was zoos before there was, I never thought anything of zoos until, I was awakened and I went to the zoo and I was just sad for every animal. I could feel their pain. Every cage I went by, I could feel their pain. And so when I read that they were putting these creatures that they had created by miscegenation in cages, it just makes my blood boil. So they're showing off their handiwork. So none of these females that they created had offspring begotten. Not one of them. None. They created nothing. Their creatures were born soulless and incapable of procreation. And then they're saying out loud, by two kinds combined, a curse has been created. Let the essences of Adamu and Tiamat afresh examine. So they can't. Yahuwah, I'm sure, is just sitting up there laughing, right? Like two entwined serpents, the essences separated, arranged like 22 branches on a tree of life were the essences. We know we have 24. So the ability to procreate, they did not include. So they, two bits of the essences of more of the Anunnaki, and they tried again, they mixed it again, and you know, for acting, the whole thing was not to, Enlil May was very angry when he found out. Great was Enlil's anger, furious his words were. The whole thing was not to my liking, for acting as creators, I had opposed. This is what Enlil said. The being that we need, Enki was arguing, it already exists. So were you, Enki saying. All we need is to put our mark on it, blah, blah, blah. Thereby primitive workers to fashion, you said. Healing heroines themselves put at risk. And everybody was in danger, to no avail. It was all your handiwork was a failure. So Enlil is reaming his brother Enki, telling him you're a failure and your experiments are a failure. I'm sorry, I can't get the camera right. Now the last bits of our life essence to these creatures you have given. To be like us in procreation, knowing perchance our life cycles on them to bestow. And we know their lifestyles, their life cycles could be up to 500 years. Or back then, they may have lived, this is in the first world age, you know, or about the beginning of our age. So they came from the first world age. So we know they probably either lived to 5,000, either 500 or 1,000 years. But according, I keep thinking of the King's List, don't you? That's why I don't want to stumble up on that. Because some of them claim to live like 26,000 years, per reign or something. So a lot of, the branch of long living to their essence tree was not. So they did not put it in their tree to live a long time. So just like us, the Sasquatch and these creatures that they created with the Sasquatch have a short life. And they're still worried about Nibiru. Now let's move into the seventh tablet. Okay? The synopsis of the seventh tablet is the earthlings are proliferating, working in the mines, and as servants. And again, always, these are definitely the fallen angels. Here they are depicting themselves. Fallen angels. And that is supposed to be Ishtar. See her? These are fallen ones. Just makes me mad that they try to take, it's just like Satan, he's always trying to take credit for God's work. Now, here's the big deal. Nibiru's orbital nearing is accompanied by upheavals. So here they are, Nibirians living on Earth, and their own planet and its orbit is coming through and making upheavals. Enki and Marduk explore the moon and find it completely inhospitable. Then Enki encounters and mates with two earthling females. So we know that, like I just said, this was right at the time that, you know, that humans had fallen into the garden and Eve was seduced. So one of these women was no doubt Eve. Okay, let's jump right into it. To the Abzu, away from the Eden, let them be expelled. You know, they're talking about from the Eden to the Abzu, Adumu and Tumat were expelled. In an enclosure among the trees, Enki them placed. To know each other, he left them. With joy did Enki see what Ningjida had done to come to be. With child, Tiamat was frolicking. And then the birth giving, twins, the earth beings were born. Now this actually matches ancient scripture. That there were twins, that Cain was born with a twin, and then Abel was born with a twin. But with understanding were the primitive workers endowed, commandments they were comprehending. And we know that by the time of the flood, everyone was drowned. Nibiru's atmosphere finally was slowly healing, but we also know that it's coming back in its orbit, right? So among the Anunnaki, those who from heaven to earth came, there was also espousing and procreation. So we know that also the Anunnaki were having children here on the earth, which perfectly matches our scripture, which says that Yahuwah made them watch their own children die. And how did he do that? Because by Enki's own tablets, it says here, we'll get to it, how they were actually circling up above in UFOs, watching their children drown. So, to them on Earth, sons and daughters were born through, by the life cycles of Nibiru, were they endowed. That means they lived up to 1,000 years, or by their own records, the King's List, for instance. It's, I think, a 26,000-year lifespan. By Earth cycles were they quickened, so they aged faster when they stayed here. Who on Nibiru in diapers would still be on Earth became a child. Who on Nibiru began to crawl when on Earth was running around. Okay? So, when a third generation of Anunnaki on Earth was present, they were all happy. So they were here for quite some time before the flood. Upon the earth, the heat began increasing. Now listen to this, because this pertains to us. Climate change, anybody? Listen. Upon the earth, the heat was increasing. The snow-white parts to water were melting. The bars of the seas, the ocean, were not containing. From the depths of the earth, volcanoes were fire and brimstones belching. The grounds were trembling each time the earth was shaking. In the lower world, the snow-white-hued place, the earth was grumbling. At the tip of the Abzu, Enki, a place for observing, established. A thing unknown, an untoward thing, thereunder is brewing, Nurgle to his father, Enki, said. In Nibiruki, that's one of their cities, the place of the bond, heaven and earth, Enlil, the heavenly circuits, was watching. So they're up there watching the stars going, is going on. Same as we are right now, right? By M.E.'s of the tablets of destiny, celestial motions, he was comparing. Here comes Yahuwah. He said, there is turmoil in the heavens. They have no idea what's going on. They did not control the flood. They did not bring the flood. They did not destroy humanity. Or it was Yahuwah that did, who had just created them and regretted it. Absolutely regretted it. We broke his heart. We all followed the children of Cain. And unfortunately, it's happening again. I think that's why scripture says, I will call you 1 out of 1,000 and 2 out of 10,000. That breaks my heart. I mean, if you think about it, right? Doesn't that break your heart? It means you'll have to leave everybody you ever knew and loved behind. 1 out of 1,000 and 2 out of 10,000. Let's continue. There is turmoil in the heavens, Enlil to his brother Enki said. For the planet Lamu, that is Mars, the place of the way station, Marduk, very evil, evil serpentine man, to Enki, his father, there you go, Enki is his father, Enki is, you know, this reptilian, shapeshifter. Anyway, so Marduk, this slimy serpent to Enki, his father, was complaining, strong winds are disturbing, annoying dust storms they are raising. Marduk to his father Enki, words was beaming. So he was literally on the radio calling his dad. It's Big Red. It's a Texas thing. What can I say? It's basically sugar water. Okay. In the hammered bracelet, turmoils are occurring. What's the hammered bracelet? The Milky Way, we know. And upon the earth, brimstones from the skies were falling. Pitiless demons, havoc causing, violently the earth they approached. Into flaming fires in the skies they were bursting. In a clear day, darkness they were causing. With storms and evil winds they raged around. Like stony missiles, the earth they were attacking. Kingu, which is Earth's moon, and Lamu, Mars, too, by these havocs were afflicted. The faces of all three with countless scars were covered. Isn't this interesting? Right? The Earth and Moon and Lamu, a calamity unknown, are facing. These are not gods. They have no idea what's coming. Yahuwah is in charge, right? All glory to the Most High. And now people say Sun Simulator. Ugh. From Nibiru, the savants were responding. The hearts were not calming down. In the heavens, the family of the sun were taking stations. All the planets were doing crazy things. The celestials, of whom Earth is the seventh in a row, were choosing their places. In the heavens, Nibiru came approaching. The sun's abode it was nearing. By the seven in a row arranged was Nibiru distracted. The path through the hammered bracelet it was missing. From the bracelet bits and pieces it has been displacing. Bereft of the celestial bar, Lahamu with Mumu near the sun were crouching. That's probably like Venus and, you know, one of these other planets. Neptune or something, right? In the heavens, Lahamu, her glorious dwelling place, was abandoning. That means planets were running. They're abandoning their station. Toward Nibiru, the heavenly king, she was attracted. A queen of heaven she wished to be. To quell her, Nibiru, from the celestial deep, a monstrous demon made appear. A monster once to Tiamat's host belonging. We know that they were all taken captive. By the celestial battle fashioned, from the celestial deep made its way. By Nibiru was it from slumber awakened. From horizon to the midst of heaven, like a flaming dragon, it was stretched. This is planet X. This is Nibiru, right? Doesn't matter what you read. If you read the Irish version, if you read the Egyptian version, here we've got Enki's own book. By the day, the skies of earth had darkened. One league of its head, 50 leagues in length it was. Awesome was its tail. From horizon to the midst of heaven, like a flaming dragon, it was stretched. By night upon the face of the moon, a spell of darkness it cast. To her brothers, the celestials, Lahamu, for that is Mars, for help was calling. Who will the dragon obstruct? Who will stop and kill it? She was asking. Only valiant Kingu, once Tiamat's protector, that is our moon and us, stepped forward to respond, to intercept the dragon in its path. Our moon was making haste. Fierce was the encounter. A tempest of clouds upon Kingu was raised. By its foundations was Kingu shaken. From the impact did the moon quake and shake. Then the heavenly havoc was calmed. Nibiru to its distant abode in the deep was returning. Lahamu, its dwelling place, did not abandon. Mars stayed where it's supposed to be. The stony missiles upon the earth and Mars stopped their raining. Enki and Enlil with Marduk, all these reptilians who used to be angels, and Ninurta gathered a surveying of the havoc they undertook, the foundations of the earth Enki surveyed, of what its platforms had befallen, he examined. The depths of the ocean he measured, in earth's far corners and mountains of gold and copper he scanned. Of the vital gold there will be no shortage. In the Eden, where the survey they were surveying, and where the mountains trembled and valleys shook, and his skyship, he soared and journeyed. The landing platform was intact. The valleys of the north, earth, fiery liquids was pouring. Sulfuric mist bitterness he was discovering. On Mars, the atmosphere was damaged. Dust storms were with life and work interfering. To Earth, return, I wish. So Marduk, even reptilians don't like dust storms. So a chariot place in the Eden must be established. And so they get the crystal tablet out. And to soar toward Nibiru from Earth, we must be able. So was Enlil to them saying. And for the count since the first splashdown, the count of 80 shars it was. They had been 80 shars on Earth. Now this is the account of the journey to the moon by Enki and Marduk. And how Enki, the three ways of heaven and the constellations determine. And he's really trying to figure out what's going on up in the skies so he can predict what's coming. But, and then the Igigi are, they're rebelling again. So what did they do? What was their solution? For 40 shars was relief only to the Abzu provided. The heroes of the Eden shouted, our toil has increased beyond endurance. Let us have workers too. So they went and they got the more. They literally went down and got Sasquatch. It says, with 50 heroes, an expedition to the Abzu he led. With weapons were they armed. In the forest and the steppes of the Abzu, these Sasquatch, they call them earthlings, they chased. With nets they them captured, male and female to the Eden they them brought, to do all manner of chores in the orchards and in the cities they train them. So let the mutiny in the Abzu occurring not in the Eden be repeated. So a few more shars and it will not matter. They're just trying to get their gold and get out of here. And we know that was all from the First World Age, and Enki just now is about to start raping frolicking earthlings he noticed. A young one to him Enki called, a tree fruit to him she offered. You ever heard of Adam and Eve? Here it is. Satan seducing one of the females. And then the flood comes. Because God's like, I ain't having none of this. In the 93rd Shar, by Enki fathered, in the Eden were born. Black and white. in the tablet of Enki. He takes responsibility. Between Anunnaki and Earthling, conception was attained. Civilized man I have brought into being. And we know that that's not true either. That all that did was start the line of Cain. Even his firstborn, Cain, murdered his brother. And every person born of that lineage since, that's all they want to do is hurt people. Narcissists. Psychopaths. Worse yet, they're running our everything. They're running everything. So, including our lives, forcing us to pay taxes. I mean, what did our forefathers run away to America for? To get away from taxes? What are we doing right now? Paying taxes? Here, we have a synopsis of the ninth tablet, but let's wrap it up. I just want to show you the picture real quick. Look at this guy. He literally is half, this is their own representation. Enki divulges the secret of the deluge. And that is Enki. You can see he is a snake. And he claims to be the father of mankind. A snake man. A shapeshifter. And you see the X's. That's DNA. He's given them secrets after the deluge. All right. Let's mark the place on the ninth tablet. Yahuwah bless you and keep you. In the name of his only beloved Son, Jesus, Messiah of the world. God bless you. I love you. Keep your chin up.